nonetheless, I'm stricken. And I want to be fresh-faced and nubile for Finesse Mitchell, who's going to be in here about half an hour. He's doing the weekend at Hilarities. You know him from SNL. You know him from all kinds. I just saw him on Is This Cake? He's one of the judges.
Yeah, I saw that episode.
Yeah. Cavaliers play tonight in Toronto. They're pretty evenly matched. I think they're kind of going back and forth with the Raptors, right?
We've been able to stay ahead of the Raptors. I think they're the seventh seed. We're the sixth seed, and we have a game on them. So if we win tonight, it does a lot for us
to get
a little bit of space. Yeah.
So Raptors-Cavs tonight, 7:30 on WMMS, your FM home for the blah, blah, blah. And then Saturday, they'll be back home to play the Bulls. Hey, Joe. Joe in Philadelphia.
That was a big slap.
Right.
Okay.
Hi, Joe.
Yo, what up, guys?
What's going on?
Bill, I am so saddened by your actions lately.
Do tell.
I can't believe I'm saying this, but you are such an Indian giver right now. I can't believe you're doing this.
I don't believe that's the preferred nomenclature, Joe.
Yeah, it's a guardian giver.
Man. Well, he gifted his fandom to the Browns, and he's now taking it back. And you know what? You know what? People give the people of Philadelphia a bad name. But when Michael Vick came to this town, not only accused of animal torture and murder and whatnot, he was convicted of those charges as well.
Mm-hmm.
And we welcomed him with open arms. And look at you, acting this way just over a little bit of accused sexual assault.
Yeah, I sure am.
How dare you?
But he had also done his time.
Yeah, it's true. Your thoughts,
yeah,
Joe?
Yeah, Bill. Yeah, he did do his time. He still did those heinous acts.
How many Super Bowls did he get you guys, by the way?
What? Wait, what? I can't hear what you're saying. What did he?
I mean, I know you guys got one.
Hey, how many is Deshaun Watson going to get you guys?
I don't know. He might get.
That's going to predict the future.
I might get zero. My guess: the way things are going, the stadium's going to fall into the lake anyway. Because that's how. Like even when things are going good for the Browns, they never last going well for the Browns. So
Browns are going to Browns.
Yeah, Browns are going to Browns.
Here's a question. What if you got, I don't know, name a basketball player with a sketchy past?
I love all these 4,000 hypotheticals. All right, so let's say that they brought Bill Russell back from the dead. Is he dead?
Bill is a big-time Cavs fan.
Yes, I am.
So say this happened to his beloved Cavs.
Again, it'd have to be something that I would take a hard look at. And it might be a situation where if it was a situation like Deshaun Watson, put that in the basketball arena, I'd have to go, I think I have to step back and not cheer. And also, I like basketball enough that I can cheer for other players in other teams. I might just not be a Cavs fan for a little bit.
Right. It's true.
I don't have the fandom that other people have where their life is good and not good based on a sports team. I don't have that kind of fandom. I know some people do. Like they get really upset when the Browns lose or when they get really high when the Browns win. Like I get excited, I get a little bit bummed out, but I don't let it ruin my day anymore. Like, that's not who I am. So, and same with the Cavs. Like, I want the Cavs to do as well as they can. But if they don't win it all, I'm not going to, like, cry about it. It's just, it's a distraction from my life. It's not the purpose for my life.
Be safe.
Am I the only one here? Okay, hey, thanks.
I appreciate this little clap on that.
When I step on the scene, y'all know me. Cause I walk with a limp like a old school pimp or real OG. I'm rocking bands, I'm in the sand. I got a Red Bull and vodka up in my hand. Hey, you looking kinda cute. Hey. In that polka dot bikini, girl. Drink all day, play all night. Let's get it poppin'. I'm in Miami Beach. Drink all day, play all night.
People are freaking out at Miami Beach. Because there are black people on the beach.
Oh my God.
And it is driving local law enforcement crazy. They're banning alcohol sales after 6 o'clock because spring break is happening, and it's primarily large groups of black people on the beach. And so that gets the local authorities very, very upset. And so the.
Bro, white people, you white devils ain't no better. Because I went to Panama City, and literally the year after I went, there was no more open containers on the beach. There was no more parties after a certain time.
No, that's the point. Everybody's wilding out. Mm. But in the areas of the beach that seem to be largely populated by black crowds, apparently law enforcement is taking a particularly different tack out there as parts of, you know. But listen, hey, man, spring break? Are you kidding me? My daughter's getting ready to go this weekend.
Yeah, you got.
She's going on a cruise, huh?
They gotta tolerate it, man. It's spring break. Like they brace everyone.
Well, they tolerate a lot down there, though. It's not like they're putting the cuffs on everybody who does something they're not supposed to be doing. But it's a numbers game. They don't have they're outnumbered 100-1.
But I didn't hear the complaints other than there's a large amount of black people. Are they unruly? Are they breaking stuff? Like, are they flipping cars? Like, what is wrong with a group of black people?
Ask them.
That's what I'm saying. It just sounds racist. Like, too many black people. Our stores are getting
robbed.
Well,
that's not what they said, but people are noticing that there seems to be a larger law enforcement contingent.
This is a really nice area. There's not this many black people around here. Something must be up. Do we have a drug dealer in our area? Tom.
Tom. Tom the drug dealer. So, yeah. Miami Beach. Can't get any booze after 6 o'clock after a violent spring break season. Yeah, they've had a couple of shootings, and
I feel like
spring break.
I feel like this is going to backfire in a way where people are like, okay, so now we just have to buy all the booze during the day, and we have it all now, so we're going to drink it. Like, it's just
anyway.
People are still going to drink it a lot. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You just have to plan ahead, and you know how drunk people love to plan ahead.
The thing they're best at.
Uh-huh.
But would you be able to figure out how to still keep drinking
as an alcoholic?
Yes.
Yeah, bro, come on.
Businesses
so many.
In the area have to close by midnight in order to give time for patrons to get to their hotels. Jason Cortex, what a great name. Jason Cortex, a visitor from New York, said, I've never been told what to do here before. I think that's insane. We're from New York City. We don't like that stuff. Yeah, no cops in New York. 5 people injured in 2 separate shootings over the weekend. 9 officers have been hurt, dealing with huge crowds. Man, it would suck to be a cop during spring break in Miami. I mean, if you're in Fargo, North Dakota, who cares, right? Nobody going up there.
Yeah, nobody's running out. It's like, it's 32 degrees.
Shorts. Bah, bah, bah,
bah. And there are people in shorts in 32 degree weather.
In Fargo.
In Fargo, for sure.
For them, they don't care. Yeah. It's a statement. It's an affectation. They want you to know that they don't care how cold it is. They're going to wear shorts. You're going to see my legs year-round. What I saw this year made me look at it and cringe, somebody said. There was gunfire coming from all over the place. But again, isn't that spring break? People drinking.
I don't know if gunfire is like a typical spring break.
Gunfire is a typical thing anywhere in the United States. Yes. Especially spring break, where you have large clumps of drunk people. I mean, you'll have shootings of people walking out of nightclubs on a Thursday. So hell yeah, there's going to be some stuff at spring break.
I guess when I think spring break, I don't think shootings.
Well, maybe you should.
You're right. That's on me.
Maybe you should. Alan, why don't Poundcake and his family join Mary and her family in Las Vegas?
My family's not going to Las Vegas.
Not yet.
My family might not go either, the way they acting.
If you want to come to our lake house in June, you can come. You can get all this firsthand, all this drama.
No, we got too much of our own. We got too much of our own.
Be a powder keg of drama.
I was just saying, my family is not like a vacation family. Like, we don't do stuff like this together. The last time we took a family vacation, I think it was like when I was 17, and that's when I came out to my mom. And I ruined the trip, so we never went on a vacation together since.
Ruined the trip. Last time we went on vacation, you told me you were gay.
That's what it was. She was like, every time I take a vacation, one of my kids turns gay.
Yeah.
No more vacations.
No, I took one. I have two kids. I'm not pushing it.
I am not a whore.
So when you guys go out to Las Vegas, you'll really have, how many days?
It's going to be like four.
4 days. Mm-hmm. How far into it the Derek Hough Show will be like towards the end?
That's what we are trying to, that's the thing. We haven't decided yet. And my brother's already looking at rental cars and we haven't even decided which Derek Hough Show we want to. I say I want it in the middle because when we get there, we're going to want to see the city. We're going to want to explore, see our resort a little bit. And then, you know, the second day, Derek Hough. And then after that, we still have the rest of the week. Like, wasn't that show so great? Let's go buy a t-shirt. Then, Mom, you can wear your little Derek Hough t-shirt or on the strip with your little penis straw. And we can go buy some knickknacks and then come home. But I want time to do things. I don't want to just fly in and see the Derek Hough show right away. I like to take my time on vacation. I don't like a set schedule.
I understand you want to taste the city.
And I want to, like, do edibles. And I don't want my mom to be there for it.
Hmm.
That's why I want my own room. I want my own everything. My own room. My own night out. I want a gay night.
That's what I've been saying about my family vacation, too.
You want a gay
night? Can I just have a gay night?
I just want a gay night.
One gay night. That's all I want.
I mean, gay in like the Monty Burns sense.
God.
Alan, you don't know until you're down here. I own a bar in Cocoa Beach. Black spring break is very different than spring break.
I can believe it.
Black spring break. Be a great band name.
A lot of twerking. Like,
yeah, no white girls twerking.
No.
What is it, 2015 again already?
Mm-hmm.
They go in.
Hey. You looking kind of cute. In
that polka dot bikini. I mean, not like the guy from New York. I said we're not used to getting told what to do. You can't buy a coffee or eat a restaurant without showing a mask. Wearing a mask and showing a card. Yeah, some cities, boy, they're still very stringent. Oh, Chicago. I told Gwen, I'm like, oh, we should go to Chicago this summer and see my parents or whatever. Man, you got to give them blood to get a steak in Chicago right now.
Like, I got a show in,
I ain't down with that.
Pittsburgh in April, and they're asking for my vax card and everything already for the venue because they still have pretty strict COVID restrictions. I don't know if that's every place, but the venue that I'm performing at does.
Hmm.
When I tell you how quickly I forgot about masks, like once that mandate was lifted and we didn't have to wear them, or whenever it's like, hey, fully vaccinated people don't have to wear masks anymore, I stopped taking them everywhere. Then took them out of my car.
Really?
And then, well, I
You actively removed them?
Because I hate it. I never wanted to wear
I still wear
mask.
Mine from occasionally.
And it wasn't until I started flying again, because I had like 7 weeks off the road. And so I got to
the
airport and I was like, damn it. So then I had to get one of their little paper masks. So I was like, now I look like a douche, you know? But it was as quickly as I learned it, I unlearned it. Where I was like, oh, wow, people are still doing that, huh?
Yeah. It doesn't bother me. A lot of people still wearing masks because the next thing's coming.
I don't know. We're in this cool zone right now where everything seems fine. Let's just sit in World War III.
Never gonna end. Yeah.
That's all I'm saying. Enjoy it while you can, you know?
Now, a couple of people want to know, Poundcake, if you will, you and your brother, as a special gift to your mom, will maybe recreate that monument fart somewhere in Las Vegas.
At the show.
Clear out the show. Man,
will you crop dust your mom at the Derek Hough show? Like you're getting up to get a beer or something.
I already hurt my mom once. I don't want to... I don't ever want to feel that hurt again. This is her one time.
Oh, you've hurt her more than once.
Not that bad.
Multiple times. The worst thing you've ever done to your mother is not get her Derek Huff tickets.
Yeah.
Wow.
This cut her deep.
You're doing pretty well then.
Well, yeah. I mean, everything else she kind of expects. She's like, yeah, I saw this coming. It's just a disappointment to me. It's not you. I raised you, so this is a reflection on me. So she kind of blames herself, so I get off the hook.
She's looking, I'm like, I guess I failed, man. Yeah.
So I am relieved of every responsibility. But this is the one thing I had. I'm the ticket guy. I'm like, well, I didn't come through for her. She's like, this is not on me. This is you. You take accountability for that. And I'm not even mad at you. I'm hurt. And when she said it like that, all calm, I'm like, damn.
That hurts way more.
Damn. Yeah. She's like, I'm not upset.
She knew what she was doing, yeah. Too.
She said, I did my hair. She said, I went and got my hair done. I bought my favorite outfit. And you know I never dress up. I took the, she was like, I scheduled a dog sitter for my pups. And I took
a master class in guilt.
I took the entire week off just because I was so excited. And she was just like, yep. And I didn't even like buy any
that my favorite son.
She's just like, she's like, my sons are so great. They're going to show up for me and just, you know, surprise me with Derek Huff tickets, even though I asked for them. And I just sat there and sat there. Yeah.
Wow.
She's not playing around. So this cut her deep.
See, my mom is more straight. My mom loves a guilt trip. That's one of her favorite things. But she's way more straightforward with it. Like, where she won't play that game, she'll just say, like, if I were to do that, if I were to forget to get her Derek Huff tickets, she would have just been like, well, I hope you remember this when I'm dead, that you could have taken me to see Derek Huff and you never did. Like, that's
when I'm dead.
Yeah, like, jeez. When I'm dead one day, you're going to feel bad
about
this.
No, I get it, but that's kind of a...
She'll just come out and say stuff like that.
I hope you remember this when I'm dead.
Hey, when I'm dead, you won't be able to take me to a concert, so... Yeah.
Yes, Mom, that'll be my very first memory. As if that would keep her alive longer, right?
No, she just wants
if
you to
If only
understand.
I had gotten her those tickets.
You need to understand that one day we're not going to be able to go to a concert.
I
so
see.
Do it now.
I mean, she's not wrong.
Yeah. And then you're like, well, damn it, Mom.
Oh, Mom. Alan, it's funny how COVID and masks went away as soon as the war started. Right.
Connecting the dots.
That's right. Did you read about the Russian troops are turning on each other? I was reading this article. One guy ran his colonel over in a tank.
I saw that.
That's like, crazy. Oof. Imagine that.
There's no loyalty.
What's Russian for don't tread on me?
Seriously. I don't know how you say tanks for the memories in Russian, but I hope that's what he said as he rolled over him. God damn.
There's video of this?
Adios, comrade. No, I was just reading this article on how, like, because, you know, half those Russian troops...
They don't want to be there.
They don't want to be there. They're like, you know.
This is just a greedy war for no reason.
Of course.
I'm sacrificing myself and my family. And
well, yeah. What they're being told and what they're figuring out is very different.
Yeah, because Russia owns the media over there. Like, Putin runs everything.
The police is running it all.
Putin is running it all.
Cleveland, you can run around buck naked. Putin's running it all.
Wow. Somebody just owns that much.
Cleveland, you can walk outside butt naked. You go to Cleveland Heights, they're going to arrest you, say you raped somebody because you're butt naked. The police is running it all.
Hello.
Hello, Bill.
Hey, who's this?
Bill, it's your friend Timothy Mozgov.
Oh, hey, what's up, buddy?
Former Lee of Cleveland Cavaliers, Bill.
That's right. And what are you up to these days?
This war, Bill. This war is... It's a hard time, Bill.
Which war is that?
This war between Russia and Ukraine.
Oh. Why are you involved in it?
It's poor. I'm Russian. It's poor, poor.
I thought you were from St. Petersburg, Florida.
I am from St. Petersburg, Florida, Bill, but my family is from Russia. These poor Ukrainians.
Are you fighting for Russia?
I'm not fighting for Russia. But these poor Ukrainians, they just won't lay down. Don't know what's going on.
Why would they? They're being attacked by a foreign entity.
Bill, the point is, Mozgov feeling the pinch of sanctions.
How so?
Guess what the latest item from Russia banned, Bill, by the rest of the world. What? Everything from Russia now banned, Bill. Banned.
What's the latest item?
Mozgov's beet barbecue sauce.
Oh, no!
I have cases of this ready to go. I had to set extra special time so that when they got stuck in Suez Canal, they would still get somewhere on time. But now, they've been banned, Bill. I can't even get my beet barbecue sauce out.
Was there a high demand for it?
There's so high demand, Bill. So high demand.
Like, how many units were you moving on a quarterly basis?
Oh, probably 8 a week. I sent cases of it into the field, Bill, too.
Mm-hmm.
So that when the Russian soldiers, you know, when they have to eat each other, they won't be so bad. There'll be some flavor to it, you know. I tried to look out for my countrymen, Bill.
Well, can't you just give your beet barbecue sauce to Russian troops?
That's what I did.
Yeah, and isn't that enough to sustain you? I mean, 8 a week is...
No, they have to donate.
No. Is it a... So wait, they have to donate money to you to get the beet barbecue sauce.
That's right, Bill.
It sounds like you got a little cough there.
What's going on? I don't know what you're talking about. I feel fine as frogs.
A little sniffle?
Fine as frogs hair. Thank you. I thought I have an idea, though, Bill.
What's that?
And then I'll let you go. I'm going to change the name of Moscow's beet barbecue sauce.
To what? I think you do have a cough.
I didn't want you to think less of me, Bill. I'm sorry.
It's okay.
Bill, listen to me, right? I'm going to change the name of it so they will never know.
Why don't you put like a lozenge in your mouth or something to help with the cough?
I don't have a lozenge.
Uh-oh. Is that part of the sanctions?
Yes, there are lozenge sanctions, Bill. I can't get the Smith Brothers. I'm going to change the name so nobody knows this Moscow beet barbecue sauce.
And that new name is going to be?
Uncle Timmy's Down Home Country Flavor Licking Hickory Spread.
I think that should be the new name no matter what.
It's hard to fit on the label, but maybe I'll think about it.
Yeah, you just got to get the right graphic designer.
All right, I'm going to go drink a bottle of this crap, Bill, to try and get to...
to lube up your throat?
Yeah, something. I'll see you later.
All right, bye-bye, bud. Miles got sick too, Alan.
That's crazy.
What? What happened?
Does he know your daughter?
Oh, my. Oh, what a web we weave. All right, I got a break. Hey, Finesse Mitchell is going to be joining us briefly. He's doing the weekend at Hilarities. He has not been here in a minute, so we'll catch up with him. 35192 if you want to text.